Philly hour.
20-20 still.
In Atlanta, Georgia, on the zone, they're waiting to be surprised by. Well, here he is now! Boo. Walking in here,
like a
on
bitch.
The Imus of the Morning program, is Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
Toilet paper on his shoe.
From now the end.
Come here. You homo.
We're going to put him over here, right? Okay.
He's got real cap thing at gun.
Get the Swiss cat
over here. Come on. All right, y'all give a nice hand to Hulk Hogan. Is it Hulk or is it now Hollywood Hogan? Maybe I should speak slower.
Just speak with more confidence, brother.
So is it Hollywood? Is it Hollywood Hogan now or Hulk Hogan?
Because it's Mr. President to you.
You left that dirtbag Vince McMahon, right?
Well, no comment on dirtbags today.
Anyway, why are you here?
Well, I'm here because I was really, really upset when I saw somebody else stepping on my turf and trying to rough Ted Turner up, because everybody knows that the only man that roughs Ted Turner up is Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah.
And I heard Imus's real weak rap that Ted Turner doesn't pay his bills and Ted Turner doesn't step up to the plate when he makes a commitment.
Yeah.
Well, even though Ted and I don't see eye to eye, Ted Turner always pays up. He always steps up to the plate. So what I did, because Ted made the promise that for every ticket sold, he was going to donate $1 to Kids Cancer, to your fund, brother.
Yeah.
I went ahead and waited until the Eye Man was in Atlanta. We wanted to see him in person. We wanted to look in his eyes.
This is very weak, by the way.
No, it's real.
This is so lame. It's making,
well, yeah, you're going to think real weak when you see this check. But anyway, my friend, I went ahead and got the check from Ted Turner. I ruffled his feathers, and I'm here to present it to you, man, because you did a great job in helping the kids out, and this check is for you and for your fund right
Thank
here.
Thank you very much.
Hit him in the muscle.
So if you still think that's, hey, if Imus Pimus Smimus still thinks that's really weak, we can step right here in the center and I'll show you what weak is.
Get him, boss.
Here's the point I was making, and the point I was making is that why did I have to bitch about it for 6 months and then come down to Atlanta and get in Ted Turner's face before he coughed up the money? So he should have given me the money last summer. I think it was very nice of you to come over with it. But, I mean, I was very weak of Fat Ted and that hideous wife of his not to come up with the money when they were supposed to come up with it.
Wow. No comment on Ted or his wife.
I mean, I had to make a big issue out of this whole thing and bitch about it. And, of course, that's why you're here this morning. If it weren't for you, we wouldn't have got the money.
Amen.
You're the hero.
Yeah, so you're the hero.
You're the good guy.
You're the man.
You're the man.
You're the man.
Well, I'm glad you finally figured that out. Thank you.
Hollywood Hogan is here also with Eric Bischoff, who is Hogan's... Well, what is this campaign manager? You know, you're jumping on this Jesse the Body Ventura bandwagon, or what's that all about?
No, I'm just listening to the people, man. The people are tired of these plastic politicians. The people are tired of a lot of people blasting the United States of America for having these special interest groups and different agendas. And so, just like in Minnesota, when the people voiced their opinion, they wanted a real man to make real decisions. Hollywood Hogan at first started listening to the people, you know, after this Ventura thing started to snowball.
Yeah.
And the people of America, brother, they want somebody with no hidden agendas. They want somebody, when a bill or a decision comes across the big desk in the Oval Office, they don't want anybody playing with cigars or anything like that. They want somebody to make a decision on what's good for America and what's good for the people of the United States. I've been around the block a few times. All the stuff President Clinton is going through, I've already experienced, my friend. So the bottom line is, I've gone through that midlife crisis already. I'm ready to be the world's heavyweight champion again, and I think that I'm the man that could set this country straight and make the right decision,
right
or wrong, yes or no. I'm the man to do it.
Let me ask you about a couple of issues.
Hollywood.
Yeah, Hollywood.
Yeah.
What should we do? Let's talk about a couple of issues. Iraq, what should we do with them?
You know, Iraq, I think we should have already been in and out of there. This thing is just going on and on and on. If we'd have nailed the sucker the first time, we should have our men out of there right now. There's no reason. There's no reason to spend the people's money, waste the jet fuel, put people's lives in jeopardy. You know, we should be at home protecting America. We shouldn't be going across the country bombing people two or three times. Get it right the first time. Just like when I set my sights on somebody in the ring, I take them down the first time and I win the match. There's no reason to have to spend more money because you didn't get it done the first time. That's what should have happened.
Okay, now another issue, a lot of the Republicans are demonizing the homosexuals, and of course we heard you were gay. How do you feel about that?
Hollywood, I told you when we came here you weren't allowed to kick the hell out of him, but I'm beginning to wonder.
Well, you know, brother, from the smell and the fragrance of that stinky perfume you have on, you're definitely not my type.
Anyway, y'all give a nice hand to Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah. Hold on. You know something? You know something? We really, really do appreciate what you're doing for kids, because kids has always been my forte. I've got a couple healthy children myself, and every time I look at them, I realize how fortunate I am to have healthy kids. I deal a lot with the Special Olympics, with the Make-A-Wish, with the Dalmatian Foundation, and I really appreciate, all joking aside, what this man does for all the kids out there.
That's what I'm saying.
The bottom line is he's got a little son at home, Wyatt, and Wyatt's already screaming Hollywood for president. So listen to the kids, man.
Yeah.
Hollywood Hogan here on the Imus Center program. Thank you guys very much.
Thank you.
Son?
Yeah, Dad?